Hello everyone, my name is Tom, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to remove a virus from your L3 Antminer machines. These viruses most of the time change your pool address on your miner, which means that your miner is basically mining for somebody else, making somebody else money at your expense. We obviously don't want that. That is horrible. And how these miners work is you either maybe bought a miner from somebody you don't know, or you downloaded a firmware online from an unreliable source, and suddenly a day, a few hours, or even a week later, your miner suddenly is mining for somebody else. And every time you change the pool address, it changes back, or it doesn't let you change the pool address. And you try to reinstall the firmware, gives you an error message. You try to flash the miner with an SD card. The SD port doesn't work. You keep getting red, failed LED flashing. And I'm going to show you how to remove these viruses, because what then happens if you get one miner with a virus, if all your miners have the same password, the factory password, root, normally, these viruses spread onto your other miners. So essentially, none of your miners are safe. So please, please change your passwords, guys, because these hackers or whoever makes these viruses, they know the factory passwords. The viruses have the factory passwords. So if your miners, if your farm all have the factory password and are on the same network, the virus will spread to your other machines. So what you're gonna need to do this are two things. You're gonna need a wire, roughly this length, anything that just conducts electricity, because we will be connecting two very specific points on the controller. And you're gonna need a micro SD card. Micro SD that has been formatted to the FAT32 format. As you can see, I've already taken the controller out of the miner. You do not need to unplug any of the cables, but I do recommend unplugging this board cable because it is much easier to get the SD card into the SD port. The only cable you do need is the power cord right here, and make sure your controller, your miner, is not connected to the internet via the Ethernet port, because this will not work. You cannot flash the miner. So now I'm going to show you which points you're going to want to connect. It is the second last on this side, on the outside, the second last pin, and the second last pin on this side, again, on the outside. So get your cable or your wire and connect these points, and make sure you're in a comfortable position, because you're gonna have to stay like this for a minute. Also, I recommend you do this with a friend, or get somebody to help you, because somebody has to plug in the miner. Somebody has to turn the miner. I solved it by getting an extension cord with a button that I can just press with my foot right here. But otherwise, it's just easier if you get somebody to plug in the miner for you. Okay, so once connected and you're comfortable, simply turn on your miner. Okay. You're gonna get the blue light, and normally the green and red light will turn off like so. And what we're looking for is for both of those, red and green, to start flashing. Once both of them start flashing simultaneously, you know that you've succeeded. On. And that's it. You can let go now. You've successfully flashed your miner. And yeah, also removed the virus. So now you can go ahead and turn off your miner, take out your SD card, plug everything back in, and continue as normal. And that is it for today's video. As always, I hope my video was helpful. If it was, please leave a like, consider subscribing, and if you have any more questions or something's still not working, please leave a comment below. I will try and reply as soon as possible. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in my next video.